हेलो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू तेनाली पाठशाला। मायसेल्फ महेश कोट। सो इन लास्ट वीडियोस वी हैव डिस्कस्ड रिगार्डिंग रिडक्शन ऑफ एल्डिहाइड्स। इन दैट वी हैव स्टडीड टू रिएक्शन, रिडक्शन टू हाइड्रोकार्बन्स, रिडक्शन टू यस अल्कोहल्स, दैट वी हैव स्टडीड राइट। नाउ टुडेज क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस फर्दर पार्ट ऑफ दैट। सो दिस मे बी अ सिक्स्थ वीडियो ऑफ एल्डिहाइड एंड कीटोन्स, दैट इज नथिंग बट ऑक्सीडेशन। इन ऑक्सीडेशन ऑफ एल्डिहाइड्स एंड कीटोन्स वी आर मेनली फोकसिंग ऑन test for our detection of aldehyde group, nothing but Tollens test and Fehling test we are discussing, and also some haloform reaction. Three reaction we are going to discuss in this session. See guys, starting from Tollens test. Before going to the Tollens test, what is oxidation guys? Oxidation in the sense addition of oxygen or removal of hydrogen is called oxidation. So yes, now we are discussing detection of aldehyde functional group. Nothing but aldehydes are oxidized to carboxylic acid, that we are discussing. First one is Tollens test. So before going to the Tollens test, first we have to discuss what is Tollens reagent. Yes, what is Tollens reagent means? Tollens reagent. See guys, ammonical solution of silver nitrate is called Tollens reagent. What is that? Ammonical solution of silver nitrate. Yes, ammonical solution of silver nitrate is called Tollens reagent. So what is that actually? Mixture of these two. See, first you have to take AgNO3 plus NH4OH. This is our Tollens reagent. Nothing but in Tollens reagent, basic media is used. NH4OH in the sense basic media. So when you add these two, you are getting this. This compound is formed AgNH3 twice above plus charge. This compound is formed, right? This is our Tollens reagent. Then what is Tollens test? You take aldehyde or ketone, and remember this Tollens test and Fehling test only meant for aldehydic functional group. They will not give a positive test for ketones. Yes, you take aldehyde. What is aldehyde? R-C-double bond O and H. You take this aldehyde, add Tollens reagent. This one you are getting. What is that? AgNH3 twice and plus charge above. Right, this is our Tollens reagent we are added. This is our aldehyde. And which media is required? Yes, basic media. OH minus is required. What happens is, aldehydes are converted into carboxylate ion. Like this, R, C double bond, O, O minus. What is this? Carboxylate ion. What is this? Aldehyde. So, aldehyde, H is released, removed and oxygen is added. Hence, it is called oxidation. See, aldehydes to carboxylate ion. Correct. Now, whatever you are having, no silver, this ammonia gas is eliminated and silver PPT is formed like this. See, AgPPT. PPT in the sense, silver precipitate is formed and water and ammonia are liberated. What is liberated? Water and ammonia. To balance the equation, you write 2 here, you write 3 here. See guys, 2 Ags are there, you put here 2 Ag. And what is that? 2 ammonia means you are getting 4 ammonia here. 3 to the 2 to the 4, so you have to write 3, I think so. 3 here, there, so 3 to the. Nothing but 1 ammonia, 2 ammonia. So 2 to the 4 ammonia you are getting. Yes, 4 ammonia you are getting. 2 Ag and 1 RCOO bond you are getting. So finally, how many H? 3 H, 1 H. Total 4 H, 4 oxygen. Nothing but you are getting. 1 oxygen is already kept here. So you are having 4 H and 4 oxygen like this. Yes. So finally, what we got? Aldehydes are converted into a carboxylate ion and this silver ammonic diamino silver plus whatever you are having of that coordination compound formed from Tollens reagent, that is converted into silver PPT. In the sense, here plus one oxidation state is there for silver, because ammonia is neutral. Silver having plus one oxidation state, here silver having zero oxidation state, plus one to zero, it is called, yes, what we are doing here, it is called, the silver is going to reduce aldehyde is going to oxidize. Both are taking place simultaneously. Hence, this reaction is also called redox reaction. Yes, guys. I hope you understood. What is Tollens test? Yes. When aldehydes are treated with Tollens reagent. What is Tollens reagent? Mixture of AgNO3. Silver nitrate and ammonium hydroxide is called Tollens reagent. When aldehyde is treated with Tollens reagent, we are getting silver mirror at the side of the test tube. What is this one? We got silver mirror, or you can say silver PPT. Silver mirror is obtained. If you are getting silver mirror, that indicates in our compound there is aldehyde group is present. So therefore, this Tollens reagent test is applicable to detection of aldehyde functional group. Remember this. Yes, guys. I hope you understood. And in Tollens reagent, this chemical reaction is happening. This Tollens test is also called silver mirror test or silver test. You can call it silver mirror test. Because in Tollens reagent, whatever silver PPT is forming, that is appear at the side of the test tube. So looks like a silver mirror. Hence, this test is also called silver mirror test. Yes, what do you have to remember here, Tollens test? You first have to remember Tollens reagent. What is Tollens reagent? Mixture of two compounds. One is silver nitrate, another one is ammonium hydroxide. Mixing that, you are getting Tollens reagent. What is the formula we are getting in Tollens reagent? AgNH3 twice plus Ag plus 1 oxidation state. When you add aldehyde to Tollens reagent, what is forming in presence of basic media? Carboxylate ion. Aldehydes are oxidized to carboxylate ion. Silver amide is reduced to silver PPT. So, and ammonia gas is evolved. Ammonia gas is evolved. So, this silver PPT indicates, silver mirror indicates in our compound, given compound, there is a aldehyde functional group. Remember, Tollens test is only given by aldehyde. Again, question arises, why? Because this Tollens reagent is a mild oxidizing agent. It can only oxidize aldehyde functional group, but it cannot oxidize ketonic functional group. Yes. Tollens reagent is used for the detection of aliphatic aldehyde as well as aromatic aldehyde, but not the ketonic group. I hope you understood. Yes. This is regarding Tollens test. Second, in oxidation, second one is Frelling test that we are going to discuss now. See guys. See guys, in oxidation, second one is Frelling test. So, Frelling test is also meant for detection of aldehyde functional group. And remember, it will only give a test for aliphatic aldehyde, but aromatic aldehyde like benzaldehyde will not give Frelling test. Again, you can ask the question why. Because Frelling reagent is very weak oxidizing agent. It can only oxidize aliphatic aldehyde group, but not aromatic aldehyde group and not ketonic group. Followed or not? Yes. So, Frelling test, before going to the Frelling test, first we have to talk about the Frelling reagent. Yes. Or you can say Frelling solution. Frelling solution. Yes. Frelling solution is mixture of A and B. Yes. Frelling solution is a mixture of A and B. Where A is aqueous solution of copper sulfate. Yes. A is aqueous solution of copper sulfate. CuSO4. Yes. B is alkaline solution of, see guys, alkaline solution of sodium potassium tartrate. Sorry. Potassium tartrate. So it is also called, commonly called as Rochel salt, or you can say Rochel salt. Yes. A is aqueous solution of copper sulfate. B is alkaline solution of sodium potassium tartrate. Mixture of these two is called a Frelling solution. Followed or not, guys? Yes. So, idhar kaam ki baat kya hai? Idhar kaam ki baat hai solution A. Nothing but copper plus 2. That you have to take. See, when you treat aldehyde, aldehyde in the sense RCOH, and add this copper sulfate, nothing but Cu plus 2. Which media is required, guys? Basic media. Here also, which media is required? Basic media. That basic media is provided by, see, our sodium potassium tartrate is a ester. when you add this ester to this solution, the water is splitted into H plus OH minus. That OH minus act as a basic media is present in water. So water act as a basic media here. Following or not? Yes. This aldehyde treated with copper plus 2. Where from copper plus 2 came, guys? From solution A. What is solution A? Aqueous solution of copper sulfate. Following or not? Yes. So in Fehling's solution, there are two solutions are required. A and B. A is copper sulfate solution prepared in water. B is sodium potassium tartarate. Nothing but Rochelle salt prepared in alkaline medium. Basic media. Following or not? Yes, guys. So when you put this thing, same thing. Aldehyde is converted into, carboxylate ion like this. RCOO minus plus. Copper plus 2 is converted into cuprous oxide. Cu2O plus this H2O is eliminated. This is our red color PPT, or you can say radish brown PPT is obtained. Radish brown PPT, cuprous oxide. Aldehyde is oxidized to carboxylate ion. Copper plus 2 is reduced to copper plus 1. Because you see Cu2O. Oxygen oxidation state is minus 2. 1 copper is plus 1. So in the sense plus 2 to plus 1. Reduction is happening. Copper undergo reduction. Aldehydes undergo oxidation. Both are taking place simultaneously. Hence this chemical reaction is also called redox reaction. Followed or not? Yes. How do you detect the aldehyde group? You take your compound, which is going to be tested, add Fehling solution, nothing but mixture of two, solution of copper sulfate and B solution of alkaline potassium, sodium potassium tartarate. Yes, you are getting radish brown PPT, which indicates, radish brown PPT indicates in your solution, there is a, aldehydic functional group is present. Yes, from this test, you come to know that you are getting radish or red color PPT. You can say radish brown PPT is obtained. Yes, and remember, this is only given by aliphatic aldehyde. Yes, aromatic aldehyde does not give this test. Aromatic aldehyde does not respond in the sense, this test is not given by aromatic aldehyde. This test is not given by ketone. Only aliphatic aldehydes are giving this test. Fehling's test. So how do you detect? Using radish brown PPT of cuprous oxide. When you add aldehyde and this Fehling solution in presence of basic media, what you are getting? Carboxylate ion and cuprous oxide. That cuprous oxide is radish brown in color. Due to that, you are getting, you can identify easily aldehyde group present in that. I hope you understood. Why these are categorized in oxidation? Because aldehyde is, see here, aldehyde is converted into carboxylate ion. Nothing but H is replaced by O. Removal of H, addition of oxygen, nothing but oxidation. I hope you understood. These are the two tests. Using that, we can detect aldehydic functional group and we can oxidize aldehyde to carboxylate ion by using Tollens reagent and Fehling test. I hope you understood. Remember, among Tollens and Fehling, Tollens is stronger oxidizing agent compared to Fehling, because Tollens can give a positive test for aliphatic aldehyde as well as aromatic aldehyde, but not ketone. Fehling test is only given positively by only aliphatic aldehyde, not aromatic aldehyde and ketone. This indicates Fehling test is somewhat weaker oxidizing agent compared to Tollens. And both are mild oxidizing agent only. Both are weaker only. Among them, Tollens is somewhat stronger. I hope you followed. Now we'll discuss in oxidation, third category, that is haloform test. Yes, guys. In oxidation, third one is haloform test. So haloform test, in the sense, in this you are getting haloform. What is haloform, guys? This one. CHX3 is called haloform. CHCl3 chloroform. CHBr3 bromoform. CHI3 iodoform. Like that, haloform is formed. Among all these, iodoform is yellow in color. All are white only. So we can easily identify there is a aldehyde or not. See. Remember, this haloform test is given by those aldehydes and ketones which have at least one alpha methyl group. That is the condition. What is the condition here? Aldehyde and ketone must have one alpha methyl group. Methyl group attached to carbonyl group should be there. Then only it is going to give halophone. Just followed or not? What is the condition? This must be there. What is that? CH3 attached to CO. This R side may be H or it may be CH3 or whatever. If you put H, it is aldehyde. If you put CH3, CH2, CH2 like that, it is a ketone. Correct or not? Yes. So to show haloperidol test, what is the condition, guys? Condition is those aldehydes and ketones which have alpha methyl group only show to a haloperidol test. Yes. When you take this and added sodium hypohalite, NaOX. Sodium hypohalite. Yes, guys. Sodium hypohalite. What you are getting is, you are going to get, see like this. This is CH3 is there, no? You remove CH3, add ONA. What you are getting? See, R, C, O, and here ONA. Nothing but salt of sodium. Sodium salt of carboxylic acid. And this CH3 will take this X to form CHX3. What is formed, guys? CHX3. CH3 is removed. Added ONA. And this CH3 will take this X, forming CHX3. Nothing but this is our halo form. This is sodium salt of carboxylic acid. Yes. Sodium salt of carboxylic acid. Yes, guys. I hope you are following. So when aldehydes and ketones, what is necessary condition? Alpha methyl group. Alpha methyl group in the sense, methyl group directly attached to CO, functional group. Following or not? Aldehydes and ketones having alpha methyl group treated with sodium hypohalite, NaOX, to form sodium salt of carboxylic acid and haloform. Here CHX3 is formed, hence the name haloform test. CHX3 in the sense, haloform. You can take an example and remember, this test is only given by compounds, aldehydes and ketones which have alpha methyl group. Correct or not? Yes. So you can take an example of this one. Very good example you can take here. See guys, this is aldehyde or ketone. This is a ketone. See, CO bond is there. You don't worry about this, whatever substitution. You just see this one. This is carbonyl group, functional group. Functional group attached one methyl group should be there. If functional group attached one methyl group is there, then what you are going to do? This is going to give a haloperidol test. You are not supposed to do anything regarding this double bond. Only we have to eliminate CH3, add ONA. Correct or not? Yes, add it. What is NaOX? Sodium hypohalite. I will take NaOI. What is the name, guys? Sodium hypoiodite. Sodium hypoiodite. So what you are getting? See, everything is same. We just remove CH3, add ONA in this place. What you are getting remaining? Everything is same. Right? CH3, C double bond C. Here CH3, this is H. CH3, CH double bond C, CH3. CH3, CH double bond C, CH3. What is next? Single bond C double bond O. Single bond C double bond O. And then what is left? CH3 is replaced by ONA. Put here ONA. Nothing but sodium salt of carboxylic acids are formed. And this you know already. CH3 treated with I to form this one. What is formed, guys? CHI3. Nothing but iodoform. Iodoform is formed. So when iodoform is formed, it is yellow color PPT. We can easily identify. Yes. Haloform test can be given by aldehydes and ketones containing alpha methyl group. And that group can be detected by using this test. Haloform test. What is the name of this one, guys? You see? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Third position methyl group is there. Yes. 3-methyl. Methisprobutpent. Pent. 3-ene. 3-ene. Single bond? Yes. 2-1. 2-1. Why 2-1? Because second position ketonic group is there. 1 we should add. Third position alkene group is there. ethene we have to add. Third position, methyl group is there. We have to add 3 methyl, pent 3 in 2, 1. Same thing here we are looking. But what is the meaning here? We are getting carboxylic acid. Hence, we are having sodium salt of carboxylic acid. So, this is our main point. What we are forming here? Iodoform. We are forming haloform. Hence, the name haloform test. Why it comes under oxidation? Because ketones and aldehydes having alpha methyl group oxidized to sodium salt using sodium hypohalite. Generally, here we have used sodium hypoiodide. I hope you followed. This is regarding oxidation. In today's session, we have discussed three types of oxidation reaction. One is Tollens test. Second one is Felling test. Tollens test and Felling test are also used for the detection of aldehydic functional group. And Tollens test is positively given by aliphatic aromatic aldehyde, but not ketone. Felling test is positively given by only aliphatic aldehyde, but not aromatic aldehydes and ketones. Third one is haloform test. Haloform test is given by those aldehydes and ketones having alpha methyl group. Alpha methyl group in the sense, methyl group attached to carbonyl group. That is called alpha methyl group. So this is our haloform test. When you treat that alpha methyl group containing aldehyde or ketone to sodium hypohalite, you are getting haloform as an answer. So you are using iodine, means it is yellow in color. We can easily detect alpha methyl group containing aldehydes and ketones, easily detected by using this test. I hope you understood. This is haloform test. So totally these all called oxidation. Now in next lecture, we are going to discuss the further part of aldehydes and ketones, that is last part of aldehydes and ketones, nothing but aldol condensation, Kunze-Orosz reaction and cross aldol condensation. Those are also very important concepts we will discuss on the next video. If you are not getting anything, please see the video once, definitely you are going to get. If you are having any doubts, please comment below. Thank you. Thanks for watching.